Hey, what's up guys? Today's video we will play the best defensive deck in Clash Royale. It's actually Splash, yeah, deck when Serve the Knight, we put the Bile Valkyrie. It's way better, especially with the Splash, and Knight is not as broken as it used to be. And we summon the Tombstone for the Bomb Tower in the Cage, because I just think it's so good against all the E-buff stacks. It's great against Mortar, and it's great against E-Giant. So I really like to have the Tombstone in the deck, and I'm gonna show you today how to use it. Perfection. So if you guys don't want to miss any views in the future, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to use Creator Code Mod in the shop. I don't even use it, so just put it in here. So we're gonna get some easy dubs. Let's go. Let's have some fun. So guys, you're in the first game against Tiger. Let's see what Tiger does. So Tiger's just going with Wallbreaker. We're just going for Ice Wizard. And this is a perfect Ice Wizard placement, so I'm happy with that. He's going in with the Minor, so it's gonna be Minor Wallbreaker. If you see the Minor and the Wallbreaker, makes sense, right? But which variation? So this is gonna be a matchup again, or like a matchup in general, where our Tombstone is gonna be so good. It's gonna be good against Mortar, against Prince, against E-Bubs, against E-Giant. These are like all matchups where I really like to have the Tombstone. So I think it's kind of underrated in the game, and yeah. One of the better buildings for sure. So he's going for Hunter. So I think this guy with seeing Zap Print is gonna be a Mega Knight deck. But we have a good ground control. So with the Ice Wiz, and yeah, it's gonna be a game which we will win in Triple Elixir. We just wanna try to defend in Triple Elixir time. Then we're gonna go in. We're not gonna go in single or double, besides to have a huge Elixir lead, but we just wanna play defensive. He doesn't have a big spell, so we know in triple, it's almost impossible for him to stop. The Graveyards, they're always getting damage, at least like 300, 400 chip damage, and how is he gonna break through? I don't really know. He's not able to kill my troops, so the only chance he can really win is in single and double this time, and he knows that, so he has the time pressure. We don't, and actually Thompson's also great against Wallbreaker. So we go for the Bamber. We wanna play it high. Oh no, we messed up. Okay, that wasn't really well played. Need to be honest here. I messed up the Barbarian Bell. I said like, okay, let's go in with aggressive Barbarian Bell here, because I always want to get the extra pressure, because if I play it high, if he's not defending it, I get two hits, but his offensive, the minor left. So he should have played on the right side on the safe spot, because it didn't have a response, but that was all really poorly played. He had a way better spot, but he wasn't a way better spot. So we go for Barbarian Bell here. Easy defense. And we're just going to Tombstone here, just going to save some Elixir. He might go in with a Mega Knight in front of that, he has to. There's like no way he's not going to do it. So we go for Ice Wizard here. We go for Baby Dragon. And what's he going to do now? We can even go in now, use his arrows too. And we go for Barbarian Burl here, because he wants to go in with a Hunter, so we can't really do it. We get also a tank on the map. We go for Poison here. And yeah, that's what I meant. Like, we went in because he overcommitted. Normally I wouldn't have done it, but it's double Elixir time. It's fine. Single, you don't really want to go in besides your opponent's playing like a tank behind the tower. So we go for Tombstone, by the way, really great. Also against the Wallbreaker and the Hunter, killing everything. And I think we can even go in with a Baby Dragon first. And if he's going for Prince in the back, we're just going to Graveyard. Yes, we're going to Graveyard. He is going to distract the Prince, and he doesn't really have enough Elixir for Mega Knight yet. And even if he's going to Mega Knight now, the Valkyrie is tanking, he still needs to go for Zap there. We're still gonna get a ton of chip damage, and the Mega Knight is already dead because he lost the bridge fight. So we go for Tombstone here. Go for Baby Dragon high. And this is just great. So we could go for Graveyard now. Let's see if we can. Graveyard's coming in. We're up by Elixir. That's why I'm doing that. And the Hunter should die. Yeah, Hunter is dying. And let's see how he's gonna defend this. So we go for Tornado, just push it back. GG's well played. Nothing you can do. This deck is so strong in defense. No way for the opponent to break through our defense. Here we go, guys. Your next game against Shaheen Mood. Okay, we're just gonna give him the good luck. Larvon, one of the harder matchups for sure. We don't really have too much response or too many response against Larvon. I would love to go with a Graveyard, but I didn't have a cycle. So I hope he doesn't have Inferno Dragon. Okay, Scary Drain's poison. Okay, this is gonna be tough. This is gonna be tough. Okay, we go for Tombstone here. Okay. think it's fine. We got a King Joe activation here. Yes, he gets some chip, but overall I would say the defense was good. I think we have a quite good Elixir spot. He still uses Zap there, so I think we are fine. Going in with Isis in the back. Okay, we go through. We need to go in here. We go same lane. Yes, it's fine. We play the graveyard like that. I normally prefer to go into the other spot because that's way better in my opinion overall. But because he has barbarians, I play like that because then if he's going for right side, some skellies might connect in the inside spot. Okay, he has Inferno Dragon. Oh no, this is tough. Tornado. Good Nado. We are still alive. We are still alive. I don't know how. Okay, he's going with this. Thompson, come on. Kite, please kite. Okay, it's kite. It's kiting. Please be enough. Okay, it's not enough. Oh no, it's not enough. It's not enough. It's not enough. Oh, man. I wasn't sure if I could have played it in a different spot because I thought it's not gonna kite because we didn't have enough elixir. Okay, poison. No. Gonna lava bridge. Yes, he does. I don't know. I don't honestly don't know what I'm supposed to do here. Poison. Poison is great, yeah, but that's going in here. Can we get some connections? Oh my goodness, no, 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 no. Is that enough? I don't know. Graveyard, graveyard, graveyard. 4 HP, no. Oh my goodness, what an insane game. I did not, I thought like, okay, it's most likely not gonna be enough, but I still had to do it. I would have never been able to defend it, maybe. Nah, toughs. We played so well. So this is most likely the toughest matchup you can get with this deck. And we are still almost, we almost won it. And we even had a bad starting hand. Normally, if he's going lava in the back, we want to go graveyard. I think this is the toughest matchup, and I kind of showed how to beat it. We pressured aggressive, we knew when he's going to lava, we tried to play the best defense we can. Once or twice, I could have defended my Isis a bit better, but overall, really great game. Still going to show it in video because I think you guys were able to learn something out of that, and I'm going to see you guys in the next one. Here you go, guys. Here are your next game. So, okay, good luck. Hmm. Maybe doing this by Barren Barrel. Okay, go for Wizard in the back, Ice Wizard. Okay, he plays this lock right there. He buys this lock right there with the ban and most likely with a cannon card. I don't really want a graveyard here, I just want to kind of bait and maybe he's going with something. He's playing e-buffs, okay, interesting. E-buffs, bait. E-buffs are everywhere, but we have a great matchup against e-buffs. So he's most likely playing the Prince version, but instead of the Prince, he just put in e-buffs. That's how it works currently, right? But we have the Tombstone, which is great. He's going to the side. We're going to the side as well. Skeletons, yes, great. I'm the best Thompson player in the world. No, but I really like to play it in this spot because it's harder for him to snipe. So we need to go for Snowball. And it's staying on the map. And this is annoying for him because he can't really push into it. Poison. Be good poison. Great poison. I don't really agree with the Prince's decision. I would have played to the Princess on the left side. That's a great Valkyrie. And that's a great King to activation. I honestly go in here with a graveyard. He's going with high EVAPs, yes, but it's not going to be enough. He still needs a snowball now, and even if the snowball, it's going to be a ton of damage. And that's the nice thing you guys see right now. I'm getting a ton of damage at the same time as counter push dies. So you can go early with a graveyard if you're sure your opponent's not going to get like a huge counter push. So the baby thing is killing everything. Go for Valkyrie here. And I think we could even go for another graveyard. Yeah, we go for low tombstone. That's a great. Great tip. No! That was maybe too low. That was maybe too low. One tile too low. I was like saying, oh, great tombstone. Best tombstone player in the world. And then we messed it up. We still need to commit a nade. Okay, that's unfortunate. We can just poison here. Okay, I think I need to take a charge here. I don't really care. Okay, Just a snowball, which should be better for us. Okay, tombstone. How is he supposed to punish that now? I think I can even go in with graveyard without poison. Okay, that was bad by him. That was really bad. I really disagree with his decision there. Decision. Can he stop spamming me? That was a really bad snowball on his end as well. I think we just go in now. Waiting. We're predicting EVAPs now? Now we should have him. I don't really think there's any way for him to defend this. Yes, he can rocket that, but he's so low on elixir right now. He's so low on elixir right now. Yeah, GG's well played. Nothing you can do. We can go for snowball, but we just need some graveyard RNG. GG's well played. Lockbait, EBUBs. Easy matchup. No way for him to break through. He actually got some damage, yes, but because of my mistakes. Here we go. I see your next game against Vitinho. Good luck to him. What is he coming up with? That's the question we are asking. Go for Valkyrie. I have for Isis in the back, I would say. He's level 11. I didn't push for quite a time. I'm just pushing for videos and playing. But he's level 11. Okay, that's crazy, man. Respect to him. But he has max cards, most likely. He's giant graveyard. He has max cards. For sure, his tower, like you guys see, the ice is chipping away. But his towers... Oh, okay, Sparky. It's like kind of similar. I have like a level 11 account as well. It's crazy, right? He's like, I'm like, how is he level 11? But it's season starts, so it's fine. It's like not impossible to do, but still respect to him. But defense is going to be tough for us anyway, because in defense, it doesn't really matter if he has a level 11 tower, right? So, it's just doing a great job here. That's a great barbarian. That's like, look at the defense, guys. Look at the defense. We kind of got unlucky here. Imagine a Sparky would have splashed my tower. I would have screamed. So, he still needs to go on with a Skarmy to defend a baby dragon. That's great. Let's go. Chip hits. That's great. Let's go. Okay. If he's going, yeah, up by elixir. Ice is in the back. We can stack our troops because he doesn't have a big spell, right? He really doesn't have a big spell. I honestly don't really want to do anything. Baby Dragon is annoying for him as well. That's interesting. That's really interesting. Tornado. That's so good. Look at the Look at Tombstone, it's insane. We're just gonna play another one here. Don't wanna play T because it would give him arrows value, so I'm just gonna play behind the tower, which is still good. So in the defensive sequence, even he's level 11, with level 13 it's kinda same, like he can't break through. Doesn't really matter, this tower level 8, 1, 0. You can just go in here, this GG, well played. He can't do anything. It's just so... such a broken defensive deck. As I said, we lost the Lava matchup. We could have played it maybe slightly better, but if you play this deck perfect, it has so much potential. GG's well played. I hope you guys enjoyed today's one. Nothing you can do, even with level 13, it would have been easy victory. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Don't forget to use Critical Mode in the shop. Don't forget to subscribe. I'm going to see you guys tomorrow. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out. Goodbye, guys.